complaint of around 4% of patients to ENT clinic. Reference to ENT clinic is something stuck in the throat, or a feeling of lump in the throat, or there is a sensation of tightness in the throat. So it is difficult to treat, and if you cannot find out any other organic lesion for that, mostly it will be globus pharyngeus, or otherwise called globus pharyngeus. Pharyngeus or simply globus. So today I'll explain what is globus, what is the definition, what are the causes of that, how to diagnose it, and what are the treatment modalities. So this globus was noted by Hippocrates around 2500 years ago. And earlier it was called as globus hystericus. But evidence shows that there is no high score for hysteria in patients of globus than in a healthy adult. So the term of globus hystericus is abandoned now, and this term was coined by Malcolmson in 1968. Okay, so what is it? What is the definition of that? It is an intermittent or a persistent condition, non-painful. So it is an intermittent or a persistent non-painful condition. Intermittent or it can be persistent also, and the important thing is that it is non-painful. There is no pain associated with that. So it is an intermittent or a persistent non-painful condition of complaint of foreign body sensation in the throat, or a sensation of lump in the throat, which is a definite clinical symptom, and it is difficult to diagnose, long lasting, and it has got a tendency to recur. So globus pharyngeus is defined as a intermittent or a persistent complaint of foreign body sensation in the throat, or a sensation of lump in the throat, which is a definite clinical symptom, and it's long lasting, difficult to diagnose and treat, and also tendency to recur. So what are the causes of this globus? So what is the method in medicine if we don't know the exact pathology or exact etiology? We make so many theories. The same is applicable here also. So this is supposed to be strap muscle spasm, or it can be hypertrophy of lingual tonsils causing a foreign body sensation, or sinusitis causing a postnasal drip leading to granular pharyngitis, tonsillitis. Again, there is chance of a foreign body sensation in the throat, or it can be due to anterior cervical osteophytes, or overclosure of the bite, or thyroid nodules. But the most accepted theory is this one, that is a gastroesophageal reflux disease plus or minus esophageal dysmotility. So there is distal esophageal dysmotility causing an esophageal distension. Along with it, with that, there is hypertonicity of the upper esophageal sphincter. So gastroesophageal reflux disease causing a hypertonicity of the upper esophageal sphincter. That is from below upwards, and from above downwards, what is happening? There can be an anxiety or a depression, or there can be introversion or major adverse life events. All these can lead to an feeling of something stuck in the throat. So we can tell it as the cause is multifactorial. Okay, all these can lead to this sensation of lump in the throat. Coming to the diagnosis. This diagnosis of globus is easy for an experienced clinician. So a detailed history followed by examination with minimal investigations and high amount of suspicion. That is all what is needed for the diagnosis of globus. So in history, a detailed history should be taken. Usually the patient will complain that the complaint will be as some thread is moving from here and there. in my throat, or the patient will tell us some cotton wool or something is going, a worm is passing here and there, or a sensation of something sticking there. So, and frequent hawking sensation will be there, and all these will be in between meals, but there won't be any dysphagia or odynophagia or throat pain, and all these will happen in between meals. So the patient will try to eat more, so ultimately the patient will be obese. Okay, and also all these symptoms will be more towards the weekend, because in the weekend the patient will give more time for the symptom, for thinking of the symptoms. So a detailed history is there, history should be sought, and also ask for a psychological symptoms like panic attacks and anxiety. Never forget to ask that. Don't be embarrassed to ask that. It is needed for that. And all these will be absent in a classical Globus. Like, there won't be any dysphagia, there won't be any throat pain, or odynophagia will not be there, weight loss will not be there, hoarseness will not be there, lateralization of the pathology will not be there. If the patient is complaining any of these, all these are alarm symptoms. Okay, usually they are not associated with Globus, but if any of these are present, give more time for detailed evaluation of the patient. They are all alarm symptoms, and a detailed examination is needed for head and neck examination, detailed head and neck examination including a flexible laryngoscopy, and it is better to go for a flexible laryngoscopy than going for a rigid laryngoscopy under general anesthesia. And there is actually, if you are doing a barium solo, it will be in 100% of cases the barium solo will be normal, so there is no need for very extensive investigations, because all the investigations will make the patient more anxious, or it will be the patient will medicalize the symptom, and the all these will be worsened. So a detailed history taking is important, examination is important with minimal investigations and also high level of suspicion. That is all what is needed for the diagnosis, and all these are usually absent, and if it is present, they are alarming symptoms, so you need more investigations for if it is present. Okay, I already told you this Globus highly associated with an gastroesophageal reflux disease. So if you suspect presence of GER, so in that case you can go with the reflux symptom index for the diagnosis of gastroesophageal reflux disease, or a reflux finding score, or you can go for a video VFS, video fluoroscopy of swallowing, or a 24 hour ambulatory pH monitoring, or a 24 hour multi-channel intraluminal impedance monitoring, which is the best way for the detection of an gastroesophageal reflux. 24 hour multi-channel intraluminal impedance monitoring. So by this means you can find out if the presence of gastroesophageal reflux, and if you suspect any other pathology like a malignancy or any other condition causing this lump in the throat, then go with an gastroscopy or an esophago gastroscopy or a barium solo or other radiological investigations. So regarding treatment, this is algorithm of management. So a Globus patient coming to you, first take a history, detailed history, careful examination, and do a nasolaryngoscopy. A flexible nasolaryngoscopy is preferred under local anesthesia. And if the patient is high risk, I already told you the alarming symptoms. If it is there, do investigations to rule out malignancy or any other causes. Okay, high risk patient, do investigations. And if you suspect GERD, gastroesophageal reflux disease, you can give an empirical high dose of PPA, that is proton pump inhibitors, okay, to treat gastroesophageal reflux disease, and give follow up. You we give evidence, give 3 months follow-up. At follow-up, what all things can happen? One is the most happy thing, that is symptoms are relieved. You started with an empirical high dose of PPA. So if the symptoms are relieved, you can titrate PPA dose. Okay. Or the second thing, it can be partly improved. Then you have to increase the PPA dose. After 3 months, patient coming to you, telling that I get a partial improvement only. Then increase the dose of PPA. Okay. Then what is the third thing that can happen? Patient is unresponsive, not responding to treatment. Still the symptoms are there. Then we will do. What will you do? Go for a definitive assessment. How? That is by barium swallow. All the other investigations I already told you to rule out a GERD. Then video fluoroscopic assessment of swallowing. Everything you can. All the definitive assessment investigation methods you can do. And if you have confirmed reflux, then again increase the dose of PPA or go with the surgical techniques like fundoplication application in a very selective definitive patients. Okay. Or after doing all these definitive assessments, you cannot find out any evidence of a GERD. Then you can go with the other treatment modalities of Globus. That is, one is a speech therapy or relaxation techniques. I told you that from below upward it is the gastroesophageal reflux disease. From above downwards it can be stress or it can be anxiety disorders or it can be drug addiction or any habitual problems. Anything can happen. Multifactorial. So speech therapy, relaxation training or antidepressants like tricyclic antidepressants can be given, or a cognitive or behavioral therapy you can, or so many other experimental therapies are available like an acupuncture or hypnotism, hypnotherapy. Okay, hypno. This is all about Globus. I explained about the definition, the causes of Globus, then management and also the treatment modalities for Globus.